This is a first look at the upcoming Ubuntu 24.04 LTS, which brings top new features and significant changes if you are coming from 22.04 and 20.04. The code name for this new LTS release is called Noble Numbat. In this video, I'm going to talk about the top 5 big features of Ubuntu 24.04 LTS scheduled to be released at the end of April. Let's get started. The first thing you would notice when installing Ubuntu 24.04 is the new OS installer. This is a Flutter-based installer that brings a brand new look. It's massively different from the older one. With the new installer, you can customize Ubuntu to your needs before you set it up using accessibility features. The keyboard layout and internet connection panel looks brilliant. The installer provides two types of installation, interactive and automated. If you're an advanced user, you can use the YAML configuration file for consistent and repeatable system setups, while the interactive installation provides step-by-step installation procedure. From the Applications page, you can choose the default selection that installs essential apps, and the extended selection includes more applications. You can also optimize your computer by installing recommended drivers using this section. Moreover, the manual partition looks very neat and clean, providing more information about the drives and partitions. Overall, I would say this brand new installer offers an incredible UI that is easy to use for installing Ubuntu. Now, once you click on Install Ubuntu, you get to see a smooth slideshow that gives clear and concise information about Ubuntu. Every new update of Ubuntu comes with some new wallpapers, and this update is no exception. Inside Settings, under Appearance, you will find brand new wallpapers that look very decent on large screen monitors. This is the default wallpaper that represents Ubuntu 24.04. And one thing I noticed when you click on the appearance setting, the UI used to lag a bit while loading the wallpapers. It seems like Canonical has fixed that issue. Ubuntu 24.04 ships with GNOME 46, which brings better touchscreen support, responsiveness, and overall improved UI with better animations. The core components of the GNOME desktop, such as the GNOME shell and the Mutter compositor, have received several enhancements. These improvements notably enhance the Wayland experience. Now, thanks to all new notifications that look significantly better and display additional information about the application, you get to see the app name, the icon, and the timestamps, making the notification style more natural when compared to the older version. GNOME 46 improves the performance of the built-in file manager application known as Nautilus. The search functionality is now much better than before. Now, clicking on the search icon from the sidebar allows you to search the entire file system based on the given input. Additionally, you can now easily switch between the list or grid view without the need to reload the entire directory. It feels faster when you're dealing with large directories having thousands of files and folders. Now, when you select multiple files or folders and choose to view the properties dialog, it feels much faster and takes less time to calculate the data. With GNOME 46, there's a new system option that groups other settings like the About page, Date and Time, Users, Region and Language, and more. This way, you will find fewer setting items in the sidebar. The privacy setting is now called Privacy and Security, which includes screen lock, location, and camera settings. Additionally, the app section looks much better than before, allowing you to easily view the information and change the permissions of installed applications. Linux kernel 6.8 will ship with Ubuntu 24.04 LTS. The new kernel brings better support for CPUs and GPUs, superior power management for laptop batteries, and more improvements such as advanced networking buffers for better caching efficiency and driver fixes for the Steam controller. Next up, we're going to talk about the Software Center. Ubuntu 24.04 offers a new Flutter-based software center that provides a refreshing experience, and the app icon gets updated, which looks very simple and kind of reminds me of the Android market. The app UI looks more modern than it was before and provides an easy way to install any application. All the apps are organized based on votes to help you find useful applications, and the Snap Store provides backend functionalities to download the GUI software. Also, the Manage section looks much better and provides an easy way to update all the installed applications with one click, something similar to the Google Play Store. We all know that Ubuntu LTS release gets supported for 5 years of software updates, but if you do not really like changing Ubuntu LTS installations after the completion of 5 years support, then getting Ubuntu Pro subscription provides software updates for 7+ years. This is free for personal use, and for the enterprise, you will have to contact Canonical directly for the support and pricing. So 12 years of software updates is a long support period for a Linux distribution ever. And lastly, these are the other changes made to the new Ubuntu LTS release. No games will be included in the install by default. In other words, all the default games such as Sudoku and Mines will no longer be available. The Thunderbird Mail is now a Snap package instead of a Debian package. Overall, I would say Ubuntu 24.04 LTS with GNOME 46 is a scintillating update for Linux users, which is scheduled for release in April. It's going to be a long-term release and will be supported for more than 10+ years with Ubuntu Pro free subscription. If you are coming from 20.04 or 22.04 LTS, you will witness a huge upgrade for your computer. Now, as of now, you can download and try Ubuntu 24.04 daily build on bare metal by installing it on a separate drive or partition. And that's pretty much it. What do you guys think about the new Ubuntu LTS? Let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching. This has been KSK Ryle. I will see you in the next one.